Does it make you sad, and I don't know how else to say this, that none of your sisters that you were so close to for so long likely will get to read the book?
I had always hoped that the sisters would read it, and I suppose a few of them will, a few of them have. There was one sister who wrote me a letter. They're really not supposed to have
Right.
contact with
That seemed
me,
very clear.
but she wrote me a letter and said, "I've heard you've written this book," and I sent the book to her. And within about 3 weeks, I actually had the book back, which was astonishing to me. She mailed it back, and I said, "Why did she do that? I would have hoped she would have passed it on to another sister." But then, I put it on the shelf, and then I needed to look something up, and I happened to pick up that copy of the book, and I saw that she had written notes in the
Oh, she
margins,
read it.
little smiley faces here, or a little question mark there, or a, "I don't remember it that way," and so she was
Everybody's a
like
critic.
having this this conversation with me
How
through
wonderful.
her notes in the
Yeah.
margins, which was really wonderful.
And is that the only, do you think, response you felt very close to in that, for coming out of that life? And
Well, as you mentioned before, that not all the sisters come off really well in the book, and there's one in particular. Her name is Sister Priscilla, and she died 2 weeks after the book came out. And I was so, I was like, I wonder, like, did I kill Sister Priscilla somehow? Was she not able to face the portrait that I painted of her? And I called my agent up and I said, "Dan, I'm afraid I killed Sister Priscilla." And he said, "Oh, but wasn't she one of the really bad ones? And if you did kill her, don't you think you did a service?" But it's been hard
If we were rooting,
not
if
having
right,
direct communication with
if
the
this were a novel,
sisters.
we would be saying that, fully deserved, fully deserved.